إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر ولله الحمد.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا الله أكبر ولله الحمد.
Just to plug the wire, how do you take this thing out?
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله حمدا دائما كثيرا وسبحانك الله بحمده الكريم بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا كبيرا والحمد لله حمدا دائما كثيرا وسبحان الله وبحمده بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون لا إله إلا الله هو الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد
الصلاة جامعة، الصلاة جامعة، الصلاة جامعة، الصلاة جامعة، الصلاة جامعة، الصلاة جامعة، الصلاة جامعة.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا الله أكبر ولله الحمد، الله أكبر، 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 ولله الحمد، الحمد لله، الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا وسندنا ومولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Alhamdulillah, all thanks and praises are due to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, who's gathered us today on this beautiful special occasion, as our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned to us that for every nation there's a celebration, and today it is your celebration. Today Allah Ta'ala has given us this beautiful day, this day of Eid, this day where, subhanallah, we reflect upon what has transpired, but we also give ourselves a pat on the back because Allah Ta'ala has given us and afforded us the opportunity once again to pass and fast for the month of Ramadan. Ya Allah, how sad our hearts are. Just last night we came for Maghrib Salah. We could feel the difference. We started making takbir and we came for Isha Salah and we could see the crowd dwindled after 4 rak'at. We saw no one at the masjid. And this is the reality, Jama'atul Muslimin. The reality of life, every day of a believer should be Ramadan. Every day of a believer should be Ramadan. Allah Ta'ala has shown us
that when there's a special time and you focus on the greatest of the creators, that is Jalla Jalalu fi Ula. He is our creator, he is our sustainer, he is our cherisher, he is our nourisher. If you focus on him, Jalla Jalalu, you will become the best individual, the best that you will find within yourself, and you will portray that because in your heart you find Allah. In your actions you find Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if you live like this, as today we had a Ramadan and we were always indulging in pious actions, although we slipped up sometimes, but when we slipped up in Nisa'im, we reminded ourselves that we are fasting and we were back in line again. And what Allah Ta'ala give us for that? A celebration called Eid. Today, we see the greatness of Allah Ta'ala. How do we see the greatness of Allah Ta'ala? We started the khutbah today. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. This don't only happen in Panorama Jamaatul Muslimin. This happened around the globe, where people recognize the greatness of the Almighty Allah Jalla Jalalu. They recognize and they sing his praises, Jalla Jalalu, testifying, La ilaha illallah, huwa Allahu Akbar. There is no deity to worship except you, Ya Allah. You are greater than anything that we can perceive, Jalla Jalalu. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. Oh Allah, you are so great that all praise belongs to you, Jalla Jalalu. How great is our Allah Ta'ala, that he can unite hearts when he decides. Not when us decides when to unite hearts. We make the efforts, but Allah Ta'ala unites the hearts when Allah Ta'ala decides. And when Allah Ta'ala decides, it depends on our efforts and our sacrifices. How much are we going to put in? How much are we willing to unite as an ummah? Today we must speak about the Palestinians, because as happy as our hearts are, this morning when we looked at each other, when we looked at our family members, when I looked at my children, I thought about the children of Gaza. I thought about how do you celebrate Eid? And our brothers are dying. They are being bombed. They've gone into a masjid. All their masajid has been desecrated. But we celebrate. And we have to celebrate. We must teach our children happiness and joy. But how heavy it weighs on our hearts. That we are celebrating and our children are dying. They are laying under rubble. Parents are keeping dead bodies in their hands and running. Say, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ayn al-Ummah, where is the Ummah? Why are they leaving us? But see within this the greatness of Allah Ta'ala. Because indeed Allah Ta'ala gives them status through the sacrifice. And Allah Ta'ala honors the Ummah through their sacrifices. Because we see the greatness in Allah Ta'ala through their sacrifices. What is the ultimate goal for us as believers? He said, Allah, let us close our eyes as shuhada. Let us be shuhada, Ya Allah. Show us the courage and give us the courage of the Palestinians. Today we celebrate their martyrdom. And we ask Allah Ta'ala to give them their ajr. For indeed we don't understand their ajr. We don't understand their rank with Allah Ta'ala. But we see Allah Ta'ala uniting this ummah. And I can promise you, around the globe today, everybody will not miss but mention the Palestinians. How Allah has raised this portion of the world to such heights. Whereby nobody cared in the past. Even us, we were guilty of that. For 75 years, only a few individuals spoke about Palestine. Only a few. Only now when the genocide is happening, the world woke up. Genocide has happened since the beginning already, Jamaatul Muslimin. We must be ashamed of ourselves that we did not stand up earlier. We did not let our voices be heard earlier. We did not protest earlier. We did not educate our children earlier. But inshallah, the next generation is going to be a great generation, inshallah. They will understand. The kuffar, the yahood, the oppressors, the taghut, they don't understand what they've made alive within the lives of the believers. They don't understand. That small child of mine understand what the Palestinian is going through. And as that small Palestinian child looks and he's being reared in this environment of violence, his heart, he prepares one day to become a shaheed. Insha'Allah, our children are ready when jihad is coming. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. Jama'atul Muslimin, today is a great day. Today there's a few virtues that we want to mention about this day of Eid. This is a day where the statement goes, لَيْسَ الْعِيدِ لِمَنْ لَبِسَ الْجَدِيدِ. That Eid is not, if you look at ourselves today, mashallah, I must say, you guys look beautiful, mashallah. The dress code is to the T, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Allah has blessed us and favored us with that. But a reminder to us, as the statement goes, لَيْسَ الْعِيدِ لِمَنْ لَبِسَ الْجَدِيدِ. That Eid is not about the clothing. Eid is not about wearing the nicest of clothes. You must. One of the virtues of the day of Eid is dress your best dress. Adorn yourself with itr, with beautiful perfumes. That's one of the virtues of Eid. Coming to the masjid, taking a certain route. Leaving the masjid, taking a different route. Taking a bath, a ghusl before coming. Cut your nails beautifully, right? Shave what you need to shave. These are all virtues on the day of Eid. Malaika standing on the road as you move. What do you do as you move towards the masjid? Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. You say the takbir of Allahu Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. All these beautiful virtues we mention. But Allah Ta'ala is not looking at us because of our dress codes. Because of how nice we look. And because of, that is only a reward because of a sunnah that we practice. But, لكن العيد لمن خاف الوعيد. But Eid is for the one who fear the punishment of Allah Ta'ala. What does this mean, Jama'at al-Muslimin? We have proven to ourselves that we can abide by the laws of Allah Ta'ala when He speaks, when He commands. Now, no more Ramadan. Ramadan is left. What are we going to do now? There is still a Dhuhr that is coming. There is still an Asr today that is coming. There is still a Maghrib that is coming. And there is still an Isha that is coming. Where's our hearts? In Ramadan, everything was subject to when I need to be worshipping Allah Ta'ala. I timed my day beautifully. Because Fajr, I'm in the masjid, alhamdulillah. Where am I going to find myself? Dhuhr, because I need to be at the masjid. So I find myself in this area, mashallah, this is the closest masjid, I will go to that masjid. Asr, I will find myself here, I will be in the masjid Asr. Maghrib, mashallah, I'll break my fast, and then I will be here. And Aisha, I will be here. That is how I planned my day beautifully in Ramadan. Ramadan, I was a good husband. Ramadan, I helped my wife. I was in the kitchen, I've never made pancakes in my life, but this Ramadan, I made pancakes. Because I want to help my wife. Brothers are laughing. Maybe it's the truth. Subhanallah, was it the first time that we did? May Allah forgive us. How was I with my kids? As the one sahabi came to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, say, Ya Rasulullah, I never ever kissed my kids. You kissed your children? Your grandchildren? He looked at this as something strange. Rasulullah said, if Allah Ta'ala has deprived you of mercy, what can I do to you? Kiss your children. Children, kiss your parents. No matter how old you are, whether you are 40, go to your father, because that's the difficult part. Easy part, mommy. Easy. And you look at Abi, oh, la ilaha illallah. No, diman khatsun, ya salam. You know, it's just not the same, which is very sad. Why do we say it's very sad? Because if you ask the elders today, it was nothing difficult for them. They kiss their father, they kiss their mother, there they go. But today's children, I don't want to kiss a man. What are people going to think? That man that you're going to kiss, you should kiss his hands every day. Every day he works, he goes out, he works very hard to sustain the family with halal income. Kiss him where you are today, whether it's grade R, grade 1, grade 10, matric, university level, or professional level. That's the man that sacrificed everything. He might not be the doctor, but he's the one that provided, that Allah Ta'ala placed in your path to provide, to make your path easy so that you can be the professional today. And wallahi, when he looks at you, he's proud. But in some parents' eyes, when they look at their children, they are proud. But the heartache, the sadness, and the grief, because now that they're the professionals, they forget about their parents. It's all about the household. It's all about my wife. It's all about how I look. It's all about my status. Eid is not about the clothing today, but it's liman khaf al-wa'id. Fear Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. In Ramadan, you visit your parents every day. You phone them, Abi, Mommy, are you fine? Do you need anything? What makes it different outside of Ramadan? They still your parents. Subhanallah. We are weak, Jama'atul Muslimin. The Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam, he mentions that al-Iman yazid aw liyanqus. Our Iman, it increase and it decrease. You will find no human being that stays on a high all the time. That he's just pious, 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 pious. Because the moment we put our foot outside of the masjid, we see haram. Whether we like it or whether we don't like it, we're living in a society that is prevalent. It just happens naturally. The danger part is when we neutralize towards it. We should never neutralize towards it. That's why Allah Ta'ala says, غَدُّ لِلْبَصَرِ. You lower your gaze. When these things happen, Allah speaks about it. Allah Ta'ala don't say, okay, you're living in that area, it's fine. Allah Ta'ala commands you as men, and Allah commands you as women. You lower your gaze when you see haram. What happened in Ramadan? Yo, it was very difficult for the Buddhas. Buddhas is gewoon, kijk na, look, salam, mashallah. Even in the office, come to the office, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. People also thought, ya Rab, what happened? The boss became very pious today, alhamdulillah. You don't even look at me. No, please, no servings of tea, eh? It's haram. It's Ramadan. Can't serve me tea now. Don't serve me tea after Ramadan also. Just do your work. I'll make my own tea. La ilaha illallah. We are forced, Jama'atul Muslimin, in a society of haram all around us. So none of us are perfect. Our iman will increase like Ramadan. When we saw haram, astaghfirullah, we lowered. We looked away. That is iman. But now, what's happening? Ramadan's done. Allah, I must make up for every day that I did not look. No, Jama'atul Muslimin. لكن العيد لمن خاف الوعيد. This is the time. Remember, Allah Ta'ala has nurtured you. Who nurtured us in Ramadan? Who gave us Ramadan? Allah. Allah nurtured us. This is who you are. This is how pure you can be. Be this individual and I will be happy with you. عيد لمن خاف الوعيد. It is for you to understand that the punishment of Allah Ta'ala is severe. That you know the haq. Now it's time for you to practice the haq. You had an entire month of preparation for the 11 months of the year to come. May Allah grant us understanding, inshallah. Ameen. Our iman, it fluctuates, Jama'atul Muslimin. Up and down, up and down. When we're up, we make shukr. Inshallah, Allah increase. And when we're down, we make istighfar. Ya Allah, I've slipped. Ya Rabb, I've slipped again. Ya Rabb, it's going to happen all the time. But the main point is turning back to your Lord, your Creator, Allah. When you slip, don't wait. Because if we wait, we don't return,
We don't return. The black dots and the black dots and the black dots and the black dots and the heart and the black dots. After that, this heart becomes so hard. ثُمَّ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُكُمْ Allah says. Their hearts become so hardened that there's no dhikr of Allah Ta'ala. No mention of Allah Ta'ala. No remembrance of Allah Ta'ala that will come. And this is what we fear. The punishment of Allah Ta'ala is severe. I've covered my awrah. Oh ladies. Oh our women folk. Oh our daughters. Oh our mothers. Cover yourself properly. Don't let the day when you lay in the bier, in the cattle, like we say, that will be the only day that you are properly attired. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned about our nisa. Kasiyatun aariyat. They will walk with clothes, but they will look naked. La ilaha illallah. We are living the times, Jamaatul Muslimin. 1445 years ago, our messenger spoke about this and he warned us. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the most people that will be in Jahannam is our females. What is the main reason for them being in Jahannam? The attire. They showed to others what they were not supposed to see. They exposed what Allah Ta'ala has kept sacred for them and their husbands only. Allah protect us, Jamaat Muslimin. It does not end there. You are the husbands. What men do we have today? A man can't tell his woman who's his woman. You are my woman. And no one's got the right to look at you. So attire yourself properly when you leave this house. Where are the men of this ummah? The men see haram in his house. And the men see haram exits his house day in and day out and night in and night out. And we don't have the courage and the strength to even tell our own wives. That how can you leave my house like this? This is un-Islamic to do. We fear our women today, Jamaatul Muslimin. And for our women, this is nothing against our women. We have beautiful and great and heroine that is out there. That chase their men folk to the masajid. I'm speaking about, I don't know if it's the minority or the majority today, because we live in a society that we see it everywhere. The men must rise. And the women must stand with their men like Allah Ta'ala's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was with his family. Allahu Akbar. Jamaatul Muslimin, the day of Eid, my time is almost up. It's family time. Wallahi, there's no time for hatred and difficulty, and I don't want to forgive in the heart today. Ramadan came. Remember, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ascended the minbar on this day. Ameen, ameen, ameen. One of the things that Ameen was said for, we know already the ghufran, the forgiveness, that if Ramadan comes and Ramadan leaves and you're not forgiven, subhanallah, you are a lost soul, far from the mercy of Allah Ta'ala. May Allah forgive us, and may Allah add accepted our forgiveness during the month of Ramadan. Ameen. One important matter that Ameen was said about was, if this individual have two parents, and at the time when his parents leave this world, he did not attain Jannah. Ya Allah. Ya Allah. Wallahi, Jamaat al-Muslimin, I'm an imam. When I sit in my office, you hear the hatred in the heart from a child towards a parent. Hatred. This is my father. This is what he does. He forced me to be a doctor. I don't want to be a doctor. My life is miserable. Our children speak about our parents like that. What a loser the child will be when his two parents leave this world. Jibreel say to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he did not attain Jannah. And Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam was commanded and instructed by Jibreel, قُلْ Ameen. Say Ameen, ya Rasulullah. And Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Ameen. Can you imagine? What are we doing to our children that they've got resentment towards us? They hate us. They don't like us. What is happening in our homes that they should feel depressed and stressed about life like that?
That's why we don't understand. The best way in life is Islam. Turn back to Islam. Islam will teach you values. Islam will give you meaning in life. But we choose everything besides Islam. Secular life became primary. Deen became secondary. Wallahi, swap it around. Let your deen become primary and your life in this world secondary. Allah will give you the best of the life in this world. The West tell you no. Subhanallah, the amazing thing is, you today as a Muslim parent, speak to your own family, you say, MashaAllah, you know, my son, Allahu Akbar, out of his own good will, he came to me and he said he's going to learn the Quran full time. Astaghfirullah, what can khabiya madikan? How can you let this child, how can you take this child out of school? Om Quran te gaat leer? Will the Quran pay him? What profession will he have? La ilaha illallah. Coming from the mouth of a person that say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What happened to us, Jama'atul Muslimin? Honored is the one who memorized the Quran. No profession in the world can come close to the person who memorized the Quran. Teach your children that etiquette. My child, there's nothing greater than Allah's kalam. You can go to school till you're 50. You can go to school till you're 60. You can complete your matric when you're 70. No problem. May Allah forbid our children mustn't do that. Right? But there will be nothing wrong if they do that. You can acquire matric after you're 18 years old. The stigma that has been created that your child must be 18 when they finish school. It's unreal. The peer pressure. Our children want to commit suicide because of matric today. La ilaha illallah. There's so much fear in their hearts. But tell them, if you miss a salah, you're going to be in the anger of Allah, my boy. Ah, it's okay. It's not a problem. No fear towards the creator of the heavens and the earth. We are failing in Jama'at al-Muslimin. Our families, today is a time, get together, sit at the same table, speak joyous things, say maaf, cry on each other's shoulders, speak about the past when times were so great and now we can make it great again as a family unit. This is very important because the one who connects family ties, Silatul Rahim, Allah Ta'ala connects with that person. Wallahi, the one who connects family ties, Allah Ta'ala expands his life for him, and Allah Ta'ala set out his rizq for him, Jama'atul Muslimin, and increase for him. What a simple action of just bringing family together. What do we do today? He's rech. Play weg van hem. He's a rubbish. He's a di. He's a that. We are the instigators of fitan in our own societies today. We approve of this. We thrive on the downfall on others today. Allah protect us, Jama'atul Muslimin. Remember, ليس العيد لمن لبس الجديد لكن العيد لمن خاف الوعيد. Fear the punishment of Allah Ta'ala. And lastly, birrul walidain. Come to our parents, our children. And when I say our children, everyone that still have parents. This is not only for little ones. This is for everyone that still have parents. Wallahi, be obedient to your parents. Honor them. Raise them. Put them on platforms. High, lofty platforms. Because they are your entry into Jannah. Their happiness is the happiness of Allah Ta'ala. A dua from a parent to a child will never, ever, 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 ever be rejected by Allah Ta'ala. Never. So imagine you're a good child to your parents. Every time they look at you, their hearts and their eyes lit up out of joy when they see you. Can you imagine the emotions that go through that parent's heart? Oh Allah, grant him success. Ya Allah, this is my son. Ya Allah, this is my daughter. Protect them. Ya Allah, grant them whatever their heart desires, what is good for them. Ya Rab. Oh Allah, protect them from harm. This is what is going through the emotions of a parent that is happy with his child. But can you imagine you hurt that parent of yours? When you come into the presence of that parent, they want to run away because they're scared. They don't know what to say because your wife is not going to approve. the wife is not going to approve, so I need to balance myself. If my mommy and my wife is in the same room, I need to be out of the room because I'm going to be in a situation. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. I'm going to say it again. Where's the men of this ummah? Where's the men of this ummah? My mother is my mother, and she will remain my mother, and nothing can change that. Nothing. I'm scared because of my wife. Allah Ta'ala guide our wives. I'm not talking about the good ones. I'm talking about the ones. And this is a reminder for all of us. It happens. It's a reality today, Jamaatul Muslimin. Our parents end up in old age homes because of what in situations are at home. Na'udhu billah. Ya Allah. Ya Allah. We, subhanallah, should, when our parents are no longer, a reminder to us, go to the friends of our parents and treat them kind. Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam slaughtered a sheep. Slaughtered a sheep. When Khadija al-Kubra radiallahu ta'ala and passed away, and she went to the friends of Khadija and went to go and give sadaqah to Khadija. Why? Out of love and hubb that she had for Khadija. How much love and hubb do you have for your mother and your father? You forgot about the friends. You forgot about the circles that they were in. That's why it's important. Visit the elders. There are much wisdom in that. Sit with them. Let them relay their stories to you. Because it will change your life. It will have an impact on your life. Birrul walidain. Be obedient and treat them kindly. This is my last words for today, Jamaatul Muslimin. Our parents are valuable. If they're still alive, wallahi, your door to Jannah is wide open. If our parents are alive, listen to my words today. If you have parents that are alive, your door to Jannah is wide open. It's easy to enter. Ask those who don't have parents how much they would yearn just to see them for a moment, even if it's just a moment. Ya Allah, just let my mother be in front of me. Ya Allah, just let my father be in front of me. I just want to say maaf. I just want to say forgive me, Ya Rab. Please, mommy, please, daddy, forgive me. I've been a burden. I've been treating you so bad. Imagine mommy and daddy die without you being able to say maaf. Ya Allah, what is our status? How can we be happy in this world? How can we be happy in the qabr? How can we be happy the day of qiyamah? Make your parents happy. This is very valuable information today. If there's nothing that we take away from today's lecture, take away that I must treat my parents well and kind and with honor and with dignity. And if they are no longer, make dua for them. They are in the graves. The best that you can give them now is to make dua for them. May Allah accept that from us, inshallah. I want to say jazakumullah khairan to everyone in my community. You know, you are not my community, you are my family. If I see you, I'm happy. I've got, like, always say, my wife tell me already, if I say, no, dad gave this to me, or dad spoke to me, one father now. Because I've got so many dads. And if I look now, I see all my fathers around me, subhanallah. I see them. Just look the ones with the one-colored beards. May Allah preserve them and keep them with us for a long time, because I believe that they are the barakah in our community. They are the ones that bring the du'as. They are the one that, if they happy, if I see a smile on my father's faces, Allahu Akbar, it makes me so happy. Because I see greatness and goodness that is coming. They raise their hands and say, oh Allah, protect this one. Oh Allah, his offspring. Oh Allah, this community that is serving. So many good du'as come from our elders, mashallah. They have so much rahmah on us. How many faults do we, ya salam, do we have? But they have rahmah. They see the good in us. May Allah Ta'ala protect them, inshaAllah Ta'ala. I say jazakumullahu khairan for you to be. You are, I think we have the most wonderful community here in Panorama. Say ameen, Jamaatul Muslimin. And wallahi, I believe that here from Panorama, we're going to spread the love and we're going to spread what it is to be a community and a society. And I end off today with a brother of mine that's sitting on my right. Where is he? Here in front, mashaAllah. It's his birthday today. Uncle Farooq Pangaka, mashallah, on Eid. He's got two Eids today. He celebrates not only his birthday, but he celebrates the day of Eid as well. He really, I can say, inshallah, may Allah Ta'ala accept that he has done exceptionally well for this Ramadan, especially with our youth in i'tikaf, standing behind me like a pillar. I need that. I need all of, everyone that sits here needs to be a pillar for me. Wallah, I can't carry this community on my own. And that's why I'm so grateful today for you. Because Allah has given me such a beautiful community that I can be as strong as I am. Because a leader is only as strong as his followers. A leader is only as strong as I can never be a leader if I don't have you. So from the bottom of my heart, Eid Sa'eed, Kullu Amin, Wa Antum Bikhair. Allah grant you a year filled with happiness and joy, inshaAllah ta'ala. And Allah allow you to reach another month of Ramadan for us to stand here again. And then you can say again, and I Mawlana Khadvi is a baby, Hail Viyadala, Temavia, Hail Subhanallah. But let this happen over and over because these reminders are good for us. I almost wanted to say, sing happy birthday for Bajan now, but we're in the masjid. When we're outside, we can do this, inshaAllah ta'ala. But also, Milad Mubarak. Now to our beloved Uncle Faruk Pangaka, who's doing so much for our community as well. May Allah bless him. May Allah protect him. May Allah keep him with us for a very long time. And also, it is also his beloved mother-in-law's brother. It was last night his beloved mother-in-law's brother's janazah. On the last day of Ramadan, Allah accepted him. On the last day of Ramadan, last night, Bajan went to go and bury him. Subhanallah. Look at how Allah Ta'ala shows mercy to those who serve. Allah will show through your family, through everyone that's linked to you, mashallah, the khair and the barakah that you'll be able to witness in your lifetime. Allah allow us to see that we can witness in our lifetime the good of our ahl and our family, inshallah. Allah bless you all. Have a beautiful day and make dua for me. You are all in my duas, inshallah ta'ala. One request, everybody, if you can please stand and just take one step forward. Just one step forward, small little, inshallah ta'ala. And then there will be more space that will be created because there is so many people standing. Ya Allah, the masjid is packed to capacity. May Allah allow this masjid to be packed like this every day and for every waqt, inshallah. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Jazakum Allah khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
الصلاة العيد الفطر أثابكم الله
إن شاء الله. Just for our information, inshallah, education, at the first we will have 7 takbirat, inshallah ta'ala. And then we will proceed with reciting a normal salah for our first raka'ah. When we come up to our second raka'ah, we will then have 5 takbirat, insha'Allah ta'ala. And the Arabic khutbah will, insha'Allah, immediately be after the salah, insha'Allah. Inshallah, there's also just one request. And we know that we have a very generous community, inshallah, that immediately after our Salat al-Eid, we'll have a soft-to-soft collection, inshallah, with our takbir. So inshallah ta'ala, as we takbir, you know, see the greatness of Allah ta'ala, give for the sake of Allah, and Allah ta'ala will increase us. Ameen, ya Rabbal Alameen. Allahu Akbar. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين
اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة إن الله مع الصابرين ولا تقولوا لمن يقتل في سبيل الله أموات بل أحياء ولكن لا تشعرون ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين وبشر الصابرين الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر. 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 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك
ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله
The boys of the collection, can you start immediately, please?
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. La Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi.
Whoever wants to pay by Yoko machine, they could do that after we're done with the salah. Shukran.
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Wa lillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد
الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد
وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم الله أكبر 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 ولله الحمد الحمد لله المنعم المحسن الديان ذي الفضل والجود والإحسان ذي الكرم والمغفرة والامتنان الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله الذي أرسل حين شاع الكفر في البلدان صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ما لمع القمر زوا تعاقب بالملوان الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد أما بعد فاعلموا أن يومكم هذا يوم عيد لله عليكم في عوائد الإحسان ورجاء نيل الدرجات والعفو والغفران الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد وقد قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن لكل قوم عيدا وهذا عيدنا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فإذا كان يوم عيدهم يعني يوم فطرهم باها بهم ملائكته فقال يا ملائكتي ما جزاء أجير وفى عمله قالوا ربنا جزاؤه أن يوفى أجره قال ملائكتي عبيدي وإمائي قضوا فريضتي عليهم ثم خرجوا يعجون إلى الدعاء وعزتي وجلالي وكرمي وعلوي وارتفاعي مكاني لأجيبنهم فيقول ارجعوا قد غفرت لكم وبدلت سيئاتكم حسنات قال فيرجعون مغفورا لهم الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الأول قال عليه الصلاة والسلام: من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه ستا من الشوال كان كصيام الدهر. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله أستغفر الله أستغفر الله الجليل لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد فيا أيها المتقون أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات وبارك على محمد وأزواجه وذريته. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر وأصدقهم حياء عثمان وأقضاهم علي وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة والحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة وحمزة أسد الله وأسد رسوله. اللهم اغفر للعباس وولده مغفرة ظاهرة وباطنة لا تغادر الذنب. رضي الله تعالى عنهم عن كل الصحابة أجمعين. الله الله في أصحابي لا تتخذوهم غرضا من بعدي. فمن أحبهم فبحبي أحبهم ومن أبغضهم فببغضي أبغضهم. وخير أمتي قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم. واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم ولا معهم. اللهم منزل الكتاب سريع الحساب اهزم الأحزاب. اللهم اهزمهم وزلزلهم اللهم اهزمهم وزلزلهم اللهم اهزمهم وزلزلهم. اللهم ارزقنا صلاة في المشجد الأقصى وهو حر عزيز. اللهم ارزقنا صلاة في المشجد الأقصى وهو حر عزيز. اللهم ارزقنا صلاة في المشجد الأقصى وهو حر عزيز. اللهم انصر إخواننا والمستضعفين في فلسطين وفي غزة وفي كل مكان. يا أرحم الراحمين يا أول أولين يا آخر الآخرين يا أحد الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. رب اجعلنا مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعاء. ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب. رب ارحمهما كما ربونا صغارا رب ارحمهما كما ربونا صغارا رب ارحمهما كما ربونا صغارا. ربي زدنا علما وارزقنا فهما والحقنا بالصالحين. ربنا يسر ولا تعسر وتمم بالخير وأنت الكريم الميسر. اللهم احفظنا من كل بلاء الدنيا وعذاب القبر وعذاب الآخرة. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا أفرغ علينا صبرا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا. ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. اللهم وحد صفوفنا اللهم وحد صفوفنا اللهم وحد صفوفنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.
اللهم اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، اللهم اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، اللهم اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان، اللهم حبب إلينا الإسلام، اللهم حبب إلينا القرآن، وزينوا في قلوبنا، وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان، واجعلنا يا الله من الراشدين، واجعلنا يا الله من المتقين، واجعلنا يا الله من المخلصين، واجعلنا من المجاهدين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين، واجعلنا من عبادك الصالحين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية والمعافاة الدائمة في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. اللهم إنا نسألك فعل الخيرات وترك المنكرات وحب المساكين، وأن تغفر لنا وترحمنا، وإذا أردت فتنة بقوم فتوفنا غير مفتونين. نسألك حبك وحب من يحبك وحب عمل يقربنا إلى حبك. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله هو الله أكبر، الله أكبر ولله الحمد، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا أكبر، الله أكبر ولله الحمد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Have a beautiful day إن شاء الله. You are in my du'as. Please keep us in your du'as as well. السلام عليكم.
مصطفى جان رحمت پہلا کو سلام، شمع بزم ہدایت پہلا کو سلام، آقا مدنی آقا، آقا مدنی آقا، شہر